Okay, so now if you look around Nigeria today, you can see that the forces of darkness, what I describe as the forces of darkness, seem to be overwhelming the black man, the Nigerian, the ordinary man in the street. How do you assess this position of things today?
This is caused by what Nkrumah called neo-colonialism. Neo-colonialism is people who are trying to enslave black men through
his own kind,
foreign economy and foreign education. Because when we are doing foreign things, we have accepted slavery. When we have accepted white man's principles as superior, we have accepted slavery. That is what our leaders accept. White man as superiors. That is why when the Second Republic came, I called it Second Independence. This third one, I have in 1992, I call it Third Independence.
Can you expatiate on this? What do you mean by Second and Third Independence? Are you saying that we have always been under bondage?
Yes, we have always been under bondage. That's what I'm saying.
Now we have...
First Independence came. Constitutional Assembly, brought the constitution for us, had an election. Election failed. Second one, the masters with the guns. Our masters, not our brothers, our masters came again. And in the form of Obasanjo and Co. And draws the constitutional assembly, constitution, and we had a civilian government. Now they came back again, took the civilian government away, and then they say same thing again, constitutional assembly, constitution again. And independence.
Now, fella, let us look at governments in Nigeria, civilians and military. In whose quarters will you lay the blame for the general dilapidation we have in the country today? Do you think the civilians have been more largely responsible or the military?
Civilians and military are all Nigerians. The point is the military must know their position. Their position is always in the barracks. Military has no right to intervene in the country unless there is uprising. There was not uprising in the Union Passenger's time. Or there was no uprising before the army did their first coup. Although I agree with the first coup, I thought it was going to, because it was the first time it happened in Africa, I thought it was going to be a genuine coup. The young boys that did it were disposed of. Then the old men who wanted to keep us under bondage took over from them and killed those boys, in the name of Izegu and Ifechuna.
Now, if I get
now, when Shagari took over, they did not wait for an uprising. There could be an uprising. See, the uprising would have made it, given off a standard, so that anybody who comes will know that if he misbehaves, he will get an uprising. But they didn't want their collaborators in Europe and America to think that the economy has failed in Nigeria up to the point of uprising. So they quickly came in and took over government.
In other words, if from analyzing what you have been saying now, you are logging the masters, both civilian and military people, as against the other side.
Yes.
In other words, there's a ruling class versus the other class.
Yes.
It doesn't matter where they come.
Doesn't matter where they come from.
And they could even be white people.
They could even be white people.
Okay. Yes.
So you see, it's not a matter of civilian or military. They are both friends. Civilian people that rule us. And okay, what has happened to all the money that has been stolen during civilian government? Nothing. There's no returning. There's no means we can get the money back. And keep expectation is still continuing. Okay. Killer is still in prison. Financial killer is still in prison. Other people who have stolen much money more than him are out.
Are you saying that there is a confraternity to which if you don't belong and you have been found wanting, you could suffer more?
Exactly, you will suffer more. You see? So it's a clique.